Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be working on a ticket transcription slash command in Button. We'll be building off of the code from our previous videos, so if you haven't seen them yet, I recommend you go watch them. They're linked in the top right card. Okay, let's demonstrate. Let's create a ticket. And the ticket has been created. Let's send some test messages. Let's try to generate a transcript. And the bot has returned a markdown file containing our transcript. As you can see, my messages are there. Let's also test out the transcript slash command. Likewise, it has generated a transcript. Okay, now let's go to our developer portal to enable our message content intent. Okay, so in our application, we go to bot and then we scroll down and enable the message content intent. If your bot reaches or is in 100 servers or more, you will need approval for this. We need this because we need to read the message's content to be able to generate a transcript. Okay, now let's go to our code. Okay, in our client subclass, we want to add our message content declaration. Okay, so we're going to want to add an import. We're going to want to import OS so we can manage our ticket transcript files. Okay, now let's work on our transcript button. So we're going to add a button to our main view. We'll call it transcript and have its color as blurble. Okay, now that we've created our button, let's work on our callback. We're going to want to defer first in case generating the transcript takes longer than 3 seconds. Okay, now we want to check and see if a transcript is already being generated. So we'll want to check and see if a file that's called the ticket channels ID exists. If it already exists in our directory, then we'll respond and say a transcript is already being generated. Okay, now that we've finished the check, let's work on creating a transcript. Okay, we create a file called the ticket channels ID in append mode and write a title stating that this is a transcript for the ticket. Next, we'll be working on going through the ticket channels message history. So let's visit the documentation. Okay, so this is the documentation for channel.history. We'll want to go through the channel history with oldest first. So the oldest messages come before the newest ones. And we're gonna set our limit to none. Okay, so we go through each message in our channel history, and then we reformat our datetime object of message.createdAt to the month, day, year, at, hour, minute, second. And then this will be a string, so we can attach that to our file. Okay, now let's check and see if the message was edited. If it was, we'll also add the edit time. Okay, we check and see if message.editedAt is anything. If it is, it will return a datetime object. Similarly to created, we reformat the datetime object into a string. Okay, now let's work on writing the message to the file. Okay, so we write the message as author, when it was created, the content, but it's cleaned up a bit, and the edit time if it's applicable. We use clean content to remove some unnecessary IDs. So for instance, if you mention someone, instead of their user ID appearing in the transcript, it'll just be at and then their username. So here's the documentation for that. So basically, for instance, an ID will transform into the name. Okay, now that we're done writing the messages, let's add some additional information at the end of the transcript, like when the transcript was generated and some other information. Okay, now let's send the transcript to the user. Okay, we open the file in binary read mode, and we follow up and send the file. In Discord, we call the transcript the channel's name. Okay, now let's remove the file. Okay, now let's work on our transcript slash command. Okay, this is our transcript slash command. Its description is generates a transcript for a ticket. Okay, now let's check and see if the channel that the slash command was executed in is a ticket. If it's not, then we'll respond saying this isn't a ticket. Okay, we can copy and paste our transcript button code here. Okay, now let's run our code. Okay, now let's go to Discord. Let's try to generate a transcript. And a transcript file has been generated. Let's use the transcript slash command. And a transcript file has been returned. If we try to spam the transcript button, it says the transcript is already being generated. Okay, so this is it for episode 4. We'll be working on some additional features in later videos like cooldowns, button cooldowns, permissions checks, etc. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. It'll really help out the channel. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. The link is on screen. Thank you for watching.